Hello heroes, this is How to GoPro channel. Today we are talking about filming at night on GoPro. Maybe some of you want to shoot videos in the evening or at night time, but the GoPro is too sensitive to light. I want to show you my process and how I work with GoPro footage to get the best results and make most professional video possible. So, the first thing we have to do is the correct settings before filming. As you know, GoPro cameras have 2.8 aperture and you can't change it. So what can you change? I prefer to use 2.7K resolution in 30fps and wide fog. Pro tune settings are very important if you are going to make color correction and noise reduction in post. So I always turn it on. I set flat color, white balance native, ISO 400 or 800, shutter speed auto, AV 0 and sharpness low. In my opinion, these settings are the best for making advanced editing. Before starting filming, you have to choose the best position which is close to a light. It needs to get the best footage quality. The next rule is no movement at all. Just shoot in one direction. In each video must be some uniform play, at least in several frames of it, for better noise recognition. You'll see it in my example and understand what I mean. So we have this video and let's get started editing. I turn off the audio and shoot the first frame. Okay, first we have to reduce noise. I usually use Neat Video plugin for that. If you are interested in, you may find link in the description below. So go to effects and put Neat and you see reduce noise. Drag it into our video. Then go to effect controls where we can see our plugin and work with it. Temporal filter radius is very important. It's amazing thing for improving quality of reduced noise. You can see quantity of frames which plugin will analyze for removing noise. More radius gives you better results but rendering will be more longer. I prefer to use 5, but you may use 3 or 4 frames if your machine isn't good enough. Okay, now let's check good frame for analyzing. This frame must have some area with the same pixels for that. Then click in front of Reduce Noise plugin to work with. All we need to do to click on Auto Profile and the plugin automatically choose place on your screen for analyzing. Its minimum size for normal working is 128 by 128 pixels, but for more accuracy I recommend to make a larger square and try to find appropriate uniform area. If it isn't possible, just close the window and choose another frame. Now it's okay for me. It's really big and maximum square. Then go to noise filter settings where we can see the result and noise reduce. Just click to see original and compare them. If result is good, just click apply. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. So don't forget, even if you haven't got any uniform area like this in your scenery during the filming, you can turn upwards or sideways your camera at the end of the video for several seconds to get such frames for better noise recognizing in post. It's just a little trick and secret for getting good frames for noise reduction. Next we have to do some color correction. Now I show you one of the easiest way for that. We need lumetri color and lumetri scopes. You can always add them from window menu. Create adjustment layer where we will do all our editing. And drag it over the video. So you can see lumetri scopes, where the lowest level close to zero is our blacks, and the highest level up to 100 is our whites. Lumetri colors consist of many functions and opportunities like basic correction, creative, curves, secondary. And the easiest way, which I recommend especially for beginners, is curves, where blacks and whites are understandable. The same things with blacks and whites is about lumetri scopes as well. Now I show you. We have to down blacks closely till to zero, but no more. If you put down too much, tails will be lost like that. The same thing is about whites and 100 point on lumetri scopes. Okay, I like it. So, The last things we have to do, add some sharpness. For that, choose creative mode. I prefer to use from 15 to 40, it depends. For viewing result online, choose some part of the video and render it. For that video, 40 sharpness is okay for me, I like it. So that's before and after night GoPro footage. So if you like the video, please thumbs up and subscribe for more.